Good day, sir. My name is Temi from the Nigerian Diaspora TV. Please, may we know you?
My name is Prince T M Ugbodaga. I'm the zonal leader of Zone 3 in Esako Central, and Anegbete precisely. That's who I am. I'm a PDP leader, a politician, and a businessman.
Okay. Now, let me add to that. Yesterday, I was with you at the palace. I saw you distributing face shields. What is your perspective on the issue of COVID-19 containment, given the fact that most of our people, you know, don't believe that there's COVID-19? I see that you're making a very good move by trying to create an awareness with this distribution. What's the secret behind it, sir?
We are in a rural community, and you know, COVID-19 is a pandemic that has challenged the entire world. It does not, it has no legs, it does not move itself, it doesn't fly on the air. And we're expecting His Excellency, the Governor of Edo State, Governor Obaseki, and his deputy, Philip Shaibu, to be hosted in Anambra tomorrow for a rally. And we expect the influx of dignitaries that are going to come with him from the city. So I decide to protect my community people as a community effort to protect them against any influx of COVID-19, coronavirus, into the community to protect everybody.
Thank you, Prince Ugbodaga. I also want to ask you, it seems that there's been a massive switchover of our communities here, Anambra and maybe South Uneme, from the previous ruling party APC to the PDP. What do you think is the reason for this?
Well, it has Anambra had come to stay with PDP. South Uneme had come to stay with PDP. You know, in the past we've been voting along the line of the party in government and the road that was constructed by the former governor Adam Oshomole, and for that reason we have in 3 consecutive times given him our total support. But we discovered that he brought the Ikubed governor 4 years ago and introduced him to us as our in-law, that the Ikubed governor's younger sister is married to our son, Clement Agba, the current Minister of States for Finance. And then we queued behind him and voted for him. So now he's the governor, and we expect him to continue his good work, because we saw that he's doing a lot of work in Edo State. And the people of Edo State are happy with the governor and his current strike with Philip Shaibu. They thought that 4 years is not just enough for a governor to be able to change development stride in the whole central district of Edo State, that if he have a second time, he'll therefore not remember us, because we know he's doing so much in Edo South now. We have not really seen anything here in Edo North, but we know that with a second term, we'll get development to Anambra, like he has promised that the 20-kilometer Anambra Ugboha road, that he's going to do it. And then we have told the community this is what the governor had promised, and the community en masse have left APC to join PDP. So today, with the job is very easy for us, because the people they've heard us and we are leading them the way they want, and PDP is investing a lot of APC to their food.
Thank you very much. Speaking of tomorrow, we can conveniently say that we should be expecting a very huge crowd of the campees tomorrow. That's on the one hand. And then secondly, that now that you have mentioned the road that was constructed by Shimali, there's a certain school of thoughts of development that, you know, currently that says that development has gone beyond, I mean, politics has gone beyond construction of roads, because, you know, fine Nigerian politicians towards the the election end of the election cycle, they start coming up with all these kind of projects. You know, isn't there more to development than just construction of roads? We agree that the roads will evacuate our manufactured products to the markets in the urban centers and all of that. But the development of our human resources, you know, human capital development, we don't seem, our governments don't seem to put enough emphasis there. What do you have to say about this?
Well, I thank you for this question. You see, we in the World 9 and I got to speak of the Ugboha and the Ugboha Road, because you know, everywhere in the world today, empowerment of youths, engaging them to work is what is paramount everywhere. Now, on that road, we just mentioned that the governor promised he will die for us. There is a factory, there's our son who put a factory there. Before now, you used to see different tribes living in Anegbete, different people there. Children that are serving IT, youth corpus, there used to be influx of those kind of people here. But because that road now is bad, the company is not producing in her optima, you see that those people, they have to downsize because of the coronavirus. They have to cut more than 70% of their workers. And so it's affecting the developmental stride of this community. So, you know, we are rural area and waterlogged area. If what we need now are developmental roads, because we know that road will bring a lot of more industry to our community. And then, you see, we're excited that this governor, he has not done any infrastructure here, but he's one of the very first governor who had empowered our youth with this Edo Best. Some of our youth are employed there. And then we've never had it this good in government. We have first time we're having an elective position in South Uneme. We have a vice chairman from the local government here. We have SSA here. We have SAs here. We've never had it good like this. So we are happy with the government. And we know he will do more. He was able to achieve all this with the stress he was getting from a godfather. And if we support him, we give him our vote today, we know he will have enough time to do his work. He won't be distracted because PDP is a large umbrella and we follow protocols. So he will not have distraction and more developmental work will come into Edo State. So we are happy to be with him. And I have been around for almost a month now. We did some T-shirts, some face caps, some B-balls to support the governor's re-election strive. And so we are mobilizing. Locally, we are mobilizing. We are on ground because politics is all about grassroots. And so we are rooting for him and the people are accepting him.
So we're expecting a massive crowd here tomorrow for declaration of support for the state governor and his election bid.
Of course, the governor is going to be wild here tomorrow in Ward 9, because apart from the one I have received already, over 300 people that I have received already, he's going to personally receive about 500 the campus tomorrow when it comes to Anegbete. So a lot is being put together for him.
Okay, thank you very much.
How's the security situation in the state presently?
Well, the Edo State is, for the past 3 days now, tense. Before now, the security situation is very calm. Everywhere is calm. The governor is doing his thing. But for the past 4 days, we heard that there are inflow of men, uniformed men, into Edo State, which have caused a lot of uproar in Edo State now. So, and then so many of us are really afraid of ourselves, because we don't know why federal government will want to, according to what we heard, federal government sending uniformed men to come and harass members of the public in Edo State. So we think we were enjoying a very peaceful atmosphere in Edo State, and that we want it to remain so, because Edo State is the heartbeat of this country. Whatever start from Edo State, I mean, flow all over the country. Like you know that it was Edo State that PDP first lost his government from. When PDP lost her government in Edo State to APC, and that's how PDP lost federal. And so we want to tell Mr. President to take precaution over whatever he will be doing in Edo State.
Thank you very much. Speaking of speaking of Godfatherism and Edo State being the heartbeat of the nation, would you say that the issue of not allowing one man decide the choice of hundreds of thousands of people, you know, as being seen in Edo State, first of all, between Oshomole and Chief Tony Aneni, and then now between Obaseki, would you say this is part of the lessons of the heartbeat of the nation to the rest of the states of the Federation?
Well, like I said, whatever happened in Edo State transfer to all the states in Nigeria. Edo State, we are well read and learned people. We understand what it is to be politicians and followers of government. I remember in 2007, Mr. Adams Oshomole, or Comrade Adams Oshomole, came up with no Godfatherism. And for that, the Benins, Edo South, they supported him for somebody that came from minority of Edo North and the minority in Edo North. He was supported to fight Chief Tony Aneni to a standstill, that Edo people should not support Godfatherism. And because of that, all the people in Edo State say, okay, there will be no Godfatherism. But we're surprised that Comrade Adam Shomoli was actually paving a way for himself to be a Godfather in Edo State. And we thought this is really not good. That no Edo man will allow a one man to decide his fate. Edo people want free and fair elections. They want to decide who rules them. And that's why you see today all the women, the market women, the artisans, the drivers, everybody, they are standing with Lord Obaseki to say that wherever he goes, that's where they will go. Because they want to decide who rules them. They don't want to anybody to force any governor on them. So Edo State said no to Godfatherism, and we're standing by that anytime, any day. We won't take any Godfatherism in Edo State.
Concerning the incident that occurred at the State House of Assembly on Thursday the 6th, Could you tell us precisely what happened, sir?
Well, it's unfortunate that people decide to take laws into their hands. We know very well that Comrade Adam Oshomole is a product of the law. For him to have the Edo State House of Assembly elected member, 14 elected members that were elected into the House, including my own zone representative that was elected, and these people refused to present themselves before the hallowed chamber to be sworn in. Unfortunately, after 180 days of not presenting themselves, the speaker or the deputy speaker went to court, and there is a court judgment to declare their seats vacant. And those people's seats, as I talk, have been remained vacant. And they went to court to challenge their seat being declared vacant. I'm surprised that such a person will now gather themselves, not only gathering themselves, going into a private home to say they are being inaugurated, they are now elected member. I don't know if they want to turn Edo State to Banana Republic when there are no rules and laws. I think this is uncalled for. To me, this is a treasonable and a felony offense. You do not have the capacity, no individual have the capacity to take people into their houses to make it a house of assembly. That's mockery of our democracy. When you are elected, you are meant to go to the house and be sworn in. For instance, the governor had issued a proclamation letter, and that letter could only be issued once by our constitution and our law. And the governor has no right to issue a second proclamation letter. And without a proclamation letter, how do you now say you are being sworn in? So this is just a way to cause anarchy in Edo State. And Edo State, with the Edo State NDG, will vehemently reject that coming together. We say no to it because it's a call for chaos and anarchy. So we reject them. We reject them. Our speaker remain the speaker of Edo State House of Assembly. And their last sitting, a month ago, already said that they are moving their city to Osadebe Avenue, the former legislative quarters, because this one is the one in Ring Road, the new one is under renovation and maintenance. So what they did is wrong, is condemnable, and should be condemned in all its entirety.
Also, sir, concerning the upcoming gubernatorial election in Edo State in September, what's your opinion?
You can see the rush to come through the back door to congregate together to say they want to impeach our governor, which is not possible. You cannot achieve impeachment under 48 hours, not even a month, for you to achieve an impeachment. They thought that it was going to be business as usual, that they will be able to defeat the governor through a ballot papers. But unfortunately, when the campaign is flagged off, they saw how all the Akoko Edo flag off, they saw the way the people are coming out voluntarily to support the governor. That is not going to be possible for them to win through the the PVC, one man, one vote, there's no way they will be able to win. And that is why they resort to blackmail and trying to cause confusion in the states. But where the Edo people are resolute, we are standing by our governor. Come 19 September, victory is going to be his. The Edo people are ready to vote in PDP. They are ready to vote Obaseki as their governor and Felishaibo as the deputy. They are ready to vote, stay by their votes, and protect their votes. So it's going to be a piece of cake for PDP in Edo State. The victory is going to be last light. Victory is going to be last light. And they have seen the handwriting on the wall. They'll be borrowing crowds here and there to converge, to say, oh, we have crowds. But when they see the real people coming out in the few world that the governor have visited, they become scary. And that is why they're looking for a way to cause confusion. But we have said no to Gofadarizi. And we're going to show that through our ballots. We're going to vote massively for PDP and the governor. So that is what we're going to do come 19 September.
Thank you very much, Prince Ugbodaga. One more thing. I heard you mention Ward 9 and South Uneme. Which communities or how is this constituted? Ward 9 is made up of which communities?
Okay. Zone 3 has two zones. In Zone 3, Sakote Central is South Uneme Zone. And you have Ward 9 is Anegbete Community. While Ward 10 is Udochi Community. Both Ward 9 and Ward 10 constitute Zone 3, which I am their leader. And then in these two wards, we have over 10,000 votes. And then in this 10,000 votes, we have collected the PVC over 8,000, and so we are ready to bring out all this 8,000 vote for PDP come 19th. So Ward 9 is Anegbete, why Ward 10 is Udochi, all in Esako Central.
Zone 3 constitutes Esako Central. Which are zones 1 and 2?
Zone 1 is in Fuga. Zone 2 is in Fuga. Zone 3 is in Fuga. Zone 4 is in Ogbona. Zone 5 is in Iriakor. While Zone 6 is in Ekperi, Ugbepe. Zone 7 is in Ogomeri. Zone 8 is Ekperi, Udaba, and Somegbe. Okay. While Zone 9 is Anegbete. And 10 Udochi. These are the zones that make up Esako Central.
Okay.
In Fuga.
I wish you success. I wish Obaseki success, and wish our people the best. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Thanks for having us.
This is Nigeria, the real home of the black people.
Great nation, Nigeria. Good people, living together in a great nation. Great nation, Nigeria. Good people in a great nation.
A home of natural resources. All natural resources are here.
Nigeria. Let's join hands together.